light is on your side.
Optional feature subject to eligibility, underwriting guidelines, review, and approval. Max credit $500. Details and availability vary by state. Nationwide Mutual Insurance Company and affiliates, Columbus, Ohio.
Come fly with me, let's fly away.
If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay.
Come on, fly with me, we'll float down in the blue.
Sing it, Frank.
Fly with me, float down to Peru.
Welcome back, everybody. Beautiful. It is the PM show with Mr. Robert Conrad.
And these beautiful ladies, huh?
This is a fun show today, Bobo.
Oh, it's a great show. Viva Belgium, huh?
Viva Belgium.
Yeah, okay.
Viva Belgique.
Belgique. Dominique. Belgique. No, viva Dominique and her beautiful daughter.
That's it.
What's that name again? Her?
Eliana.
I've got to write that down.
Yes, you do.
Eliana.
Yep.
I love that name, Eliana. So now, how old are you, Eliana?
Yeah.
13.
And do you have a boyfriend?
No.
All right. Well,
That's right.
I was just asking in front of Mom. You don't have to get all nervous about it. You're certainly a pretty enough woman. And I have seven daughters. So I don't believe any of them should see men. All right. I'm glad you came, you little cutie.
Yes, yes.
All right. Now, so.
Brian from Nashville.
Brian Nashville. What's happened, Brian? Talk to us.
Well, I forgot to say hello to Eric. I'm sorry about that, Eric.
Oh, hey, Brian, don't worry about it. Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
And welcome to the United States, girls.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoy your stay here, and I'm sure with Uncle Bob and Eric there, you're going to have a lot of fun today.
We have a great moment.
Uncle Bob, what I wanted to talk about is 36 years ago tomorrow, do you know what happened?
Gosh, you know what happened?
The premiere of Baba Black Sheep. On NBC.
All right.
And that was.
I know I'm stealing this from my buddy John, who's going to follow me, but I had to get that in. I've got a story.
Well, I say, listen, I got a story too.
Well, you go ahead.
No, the only two shows, that canceled by the Women Against Violence on television, were Baba Black Sheep and The Wild Wild West. And I say to you in all sincerity, the cancellation of The Wild West couldn't have come at a better time because one of us was going to die, and we got close to it.
January of 1968 from the chandelier, but you mentioned that you've been watching the shows. I want to say this.
Yeah, I've been watching
now
twice.
You know why you have so many fans.
Well,
because that was one show that had everything. Had the great musical score. It had also the great actor in Ross Martin, the great actor in and you, sir. Now, I'm a heterosexual, but you were one of the finest looking guys to ever grace the screen of the television.
Hey, thank you. Thank you.
And you know that.
I'm glad that Brian clarified that.
Hey, but Brian, what it is for me is a great return to a part of my life that for some reason I had put in the background, but now it's in the foreground. I love it. I don't know who the kid is that's doing those stunts, and I just shake my head and say, that kid's nuts.
Well, the stunts and the acting all came together. And it was a wonderful show. It was nothing like they got on television today.
Hey, so, thanks, man. Now,
I'm going to get off here and let everybody else call. And all right. You all have a great rest of the night and a wonderful weekend.
You too, Brian. Thanks a lot, Brian. All right.
So anyway, what we're doing is I'm sending a letter off, an email off today to Les Moonves, the president of CBS, because of the popular of the Wild West, the 5 days a week, and it's popular in all our lives. Will Smith didn't damage it. He didn't. We've recovered from that. And I mentioned to Les Moonves that I have the perfect actor to play me in the series. And he went ahead with the Hawaii 5-0 show. And if he's going to go back with the Black Sheep, I mean with the Wild West, I got the guy to play Robert Conrad. But we'll see what happens with that. Now let's talk to. The voice. Hey, we got the voice. Then we have Christophe in France, and we have the beautiful Mary. What's up, John?
Hey, Bob. Hey, Eric and Dominique and Aliana. Comment allez-vous?
Yeah.
Hey, Bob.
Yo.
May I be the first to wish you the PM show with Robert Conrad a happy 5th anniversary?
Well, man, thank you so much. And thank
has it
you
been
for,
that long, John?
Yes. And hey,
yeah,
John,
this is the 5th anniversary.
Hey, wow. John, the success is phenomenal. It is the number one show in most of the world, and it's the number two show in the United States, and it's the number one show on cable, and that's all because of you guys.
Five years.
You have many more.
I'm enjoying it. Now, as soon as I get myself rehabilitated, I'm going back to different phases of my career, and I'm looking forward to it, but I've had two opportunities. I declined because I want to be 100%, and I can't be until I'm out of pain and the surgery's done. Anything else, John?
Well, Brian mentioned about the anniversary of Baba Black Sheep being tomorrow, 36 years, and then on Saturday, it'll be the 33rd anniversary of A Man Called Sloan.
Oh, wow, man.
A lot of anniversaries here.
Hey, now you know why I'm building that mansion, baby.
Yeah.
Hey, John, thanks for your call. Thanks for your friendship. Thanks for being a part of your show. Go ahead.
Thank you, Bob. And may I say one more thing before I go?
Anything you want.
In The Night of the Cutthroats, that was the episode with Jackie Coogan, Beverly Garland, and Bradford Dillman. This was back when you were having trouble with your shoulder.
Yeah.
And you went to the doctor. And he said you had bursitis, and he put a 12-inch needle in your shoulder. And according to Dick Kanji, you winced a bit, but the doctor smiled and said, that couldn't have hurt much, but driving the needle to the hilt, he said, this sure as hell will.
Oh, man.
And I'm sure you remember that, right?
I'll never forget it. Thank you very much. I should have killed that guy, but I didn't. he survived.
Well, thank you for taking my call, and thank you for your friendship, Bob, and God bless you, my friend.
Hey, God bless you, man. Thanks John. Okay, now... For those of you that are new listeners, call in if you want to be a part of the show. You wait, and then it doesn't happen because you wait too long. So don't wait. And look at some people come from all over the world to be here, a beautiful woman and with a lovely daughter, very charmant.
Huh?
Charmant mademoiselle. And your mother, Charmant?
Charmant.
Good. All right, see, that's what we're going to do now. Well, now what we're going to do is we go to Christophe in a moment to France.
I got one for you.
Yeah, go, brother.
I got one from Denise C. in Massachusetts, wanting to know whatever brought you down to Mexico and Spain. Was it music, or did you go down there to film movies? And also just wanted to let you know that she rewatched The Bandits.
Los Bandidos.
It was Los Bandidos?
Yes, I directed it.
And that's what brought you down there?
No, what brought me to Spain was... an opportunity. I was out of money. I had been in Paris and I was staying at the airport because I couldn't afford a hotel. I had a ticket to Madrid. I got to Madrid and I wired a friend of mine back in the day when you wired, and I said, send me $250. I'm broke. I want to get to New York. And he said, hang in there, I will. And when I was waiting, I walked into the bar and this guy looked at me and said, my God, you're on my list. I said, what list? He said, I got a list of 10 guys that can possibly be the first boyfriend of this major female movie star. And her name was Marisol. So I'll tell you after we go to commercial the rest of that story, because it's very, very interesting. And it began a career that I love. I embrace the Spanish people, and I love to sing in Spanish.
We'll be back right after this.
Merci beaucoup, monsieur.
This is my dad's Mercedes C-Class. And it's a one